Hey guys, what's going on? Got our second war of the season, and today we're going to be facing Elite Squad. So, they placed in Platinum 1 last season. I know that we faced them before, but yeah, let's go ahead and get started. So I'm going to be choosing my team, and my team for this war is going to be Captain America Infinity War, Nick Fury, and Corvus. So, this one's actually going to be kind of interesting. I'm going to be starting off on path 4, like I did last war. And my first fight is actually going to be against a 6-star rank 3 Killmonger. So, I was really nervous about this fight. I decided to go ahead and bring Captain America Infinity War with a Cosmic on the team for the armor break, and the global here is going to be Siphon. So luckily his signature level wasn't super high, but yeah, let's go ahead and get started. So I am boosted a decent amount for this fight, and as you can see, this person is running Max Limber, which really kind of messed me up a little bit. I went ahead and put on a power start boost. But, yeah, the block damage with this rank 3 Killmonger is just pretty insane. And we do have the class disadvantage too, so the attack is even higher than it would normally be. So, right now we're just parrying him and heavying him. We're going to let him get to a special 2. And I shouldn't have thrown the special 3. I should have hit him a couple times first. Because after Killmonger throws the special 2, your first couple hits, he's indestructible for. So, we're just going to continue on with our game plan here of parrying him. That way we're not taking any reverberation damage, as long as he's armor broken. And yeah, I think that overall I was expecting this fight to be much, much, much worse than it was. But we ended up getting him down. So, alright, that fight's over, and we're going to be moving along now. I did not take the second fight on path 4, but I am going to go ahead and pick up a Corvus charge against this Colossus here. So, you'll see, I'm actually going to do all of this stuff on one set of boosts. So, we're not boosted super heavily, but we do have one of each on here, and I'm going to go ahead and put my cosmic boosts on as well, because like I said, I'm going to be doing all of my fights on one set. So, this is a pretty straightforward fight. There's not a whole lot to say about it. We're just going to try to kill him before we run out of our glaive charges. And with Colossus' special 1, I'm sure most people know this, but if you back up a whole bunch, it's kind of like Ant-Man's special 1, where the further you back up, the further back it will push you. He'll run towards you and not run into you until he does his little punch. So we got him down in 2 special 2s, and now we have... Now we have our first Corvus charge, which is the most important one. So we're going to move over here. We're going to be on path 2. And this is going to be Encroaching Stun, Guillotine 2099. So we're going to throw on an advanced power boost because I was told that, if you get to your special 2 before the you can almost beat the encroaching stun with Corvus. So I'm going to throw a heavy to make sure that she can't go invisible and I can't miss. So here I'm going to throw a second one, and I was just a little bit early on that one. And you can see there we beat out the encroaching stun timer, so that was fine. And then our next fight here on section 2 is going to be this Green Goblin. I was a little bit worried about the block damage on the special one because of the siphon, and he is a villain. So that special one involves a lot of blocked hits. But either way, we're going to try to hit him as few times as possible to try to keep him from regenerating too much. Got to our special two, and that fight's over. So I have almost never used Corvus in Alliance form, and he is just a super, super fast and safe option if you have the right boosts. So now I'm going to be moving up to this next fight here. And I probably didn't need to heal. I think I was nervous because I had suicides and willpower on. So I didn't want to like degenerate or anything like that when I got the infection on me. So this shouldn't be too bad. Again, with Warlock, you just want to try to hit him as little as possible. And yeah, there's really no need to throw a special in this fight either because your specials won't armor break him, or I'm sorry, your specials won't crit unless he's armor broken. But you can see there we got a pretty good intercept. Just going to try to push him to special two as much as humanly possible. And fight's over, so super simple. And now we're going to be moving up here. And I believe this is going to be my last fight of the war. And I'm going to go ahead and take this Spider-Man stealth suit. And this was actually a pretty cool fight. You'll see why here in a second. But I took a little bit of an unnecessary risk during this fight. So here I'm going to go for the intercept. I'm going to let him evade on purpose, and I'm going to knock him down. And even though this won't give me True Strike, it will give me a third mission. So now I'm going to be hitting even harder. And I'm going to go ahead and drop my special two. And right before my power was drained, I got another special two in and took him down. So, yeah. Oh, and then this was I don't even know why I put this on here, but I did go in here and finish this thing boss. I probably could have left this out. It doesn't really count. He had like almost no health left. But I did go ahead and try to finish it with Nick Fury. Got an okay intercept there. And Nick Fury is just great for Thing in general, as long as you're not giving him his protection too much. So this war, we did 100% and we did win. So great job to both sides, and I will see you guys in the next war.